Thank you. I love you too. Thank you.
An hour and 42 minutes, ladies and gentlemen. We have not had a commercial break. I would thus have to say the president's status with COVID-19 is pretty solid. The second thing that I would say is that not once during the hour and 42 minutes has the president been stumped. Has he not known what he wanted to say? Sir, you give the media in this country more access than any president ever. That's not even a contest. I think you've done something brilliant, too, when you have your little press gaggles out on your way to Marine One. The camera's on you, not them. You look like you're actually conducting an orchestra as you point to various members of the media when it's their turn. You're conducting a symphony, and everybody hears them screaming their questions at you like a bunch of six-year-olds, and you answer them. Every question you're asked, you answer. You don't take a pass on anything. And you don't run away from anything. You don't hide from anything. And you'll meet them wherever they happen to be. If you're able to, you will. And I think people need to keep this in mind in terms of a chief executive who is accessible to the American people and wants the American people to know what he's doing and what he's thinking. There's no deception here. You have somebody, I don't want to embarrass you here, but you have somebody who thinks this country is great. You have somebody that loves this country, perhaps in ways that many people in politics in the past don't, because their view of what America is a nation among many in the world. President Trump believes in America first, and for this he's hated. For this he's criticized. America first. There's nothing wrong with America first, because America's the good guys. We are the good guys in the world. We are the solution to the world's problems. You have a man here who believes this, who believes your country holds the secret and holds the answer to life improving for citizens and human beings all over this planet. That's the objective that he has, including for people that live in this country. And can you imagine folks being hated and reviled for this? And yet he is. He's hated and reviled for loving America, for believing that America is good. His opponents think America's racist, sexist, bigoted, homophobic. Hell, we may as well still be a slave state as far as they're concerned. It's outrageous how they've poisoned the minds of our young people and got our young people hating their own country. Donald Trump has been your arrival on the scene has been providential, I believe, sir. I think you are the one person who has the ability to delay, stave off, stop the left from this inexorable march of theirs into changing this country and into things the American people that aren't paying attention have no idea what's in store for them if they win.
Well, Rush, this is the... I appreciate that very much. It's an honor.
I mean it bottom of my heart, sir.
I know you do. And this is the most important election that we've ever had. And I used to say 16. I don't even get into that anymore. That's over. This is the most important election that this country has ever had on so many different fronts. There's never been anything like it. We will go the way of failed nations all over Latin America, South America. We will go the way of failure like nobody's ever seen, and in a scale like nobody's ever seen it. We've been taken advantage of by every nation in the world, including our friends. Our friends sometimes are worse than our enemies. 'Cause there ain't no doubt.